In this video, guys, let's look at five rules, trading rules that are in the textbooks. I've talked about them before as well. They're probably going to break at some point. They may well need to be broken. Stick around. Hey guys, warm welcome to you. All right, so five rules that you may need to break at some point. Now, break because, hey, we're not advocating that we break rules mindlessly. Okay, there's a distinct difference which we'll cover in a moment. So what does that mean? So it means that, hey, you've got your trading rules. I'm going to risk X. I'm going to do this. Now, you stick to the rules that you give you. What I mean by this is that, hey, the general trading rules that everyone has out there, at some point, you may need to break those, but still be defined in your plan. So while they break everyone else's rules, your rules are still very strict, even though they don't stick to those rules, if that makes sense. So we're not breaking our own rules. We never do that. Okay, we're gonna do that from time to time because we're humans, things happen. But the point is, guys, there's more discipline that we can be in our trading, in our life, the more confidence we can build, etc. But that's another video. I've done loads of videos on that before and we'll do future videos because that's a super interesting topic for us, guys, is discipline, psychology, all that stuff. However, what I want to talk about here is real world trading, right? So we've got rules and golden rules that everyone says, and no doubt I've made videos about it before, but I try to always add a caveat because I try to talk about trading in real world terms and not textbook stuff, because textbook's fine and yes, it gets you so far, but it doesn't get you all the way. It doesn't really nudge you where you want to be a lot of the time. And so when I do these videos, we talk about videos, I'm always saying this is generalizing, and I always try to give what I feel is useful advice to traders based on the knowledge that I have. Listen, don't claim to be a superstar, guys, but hopefully I'm adding some value to your trading. That's the idea. So some of these things are, you know, I've always had a caveat to them. So anyway, let's just get on with it. So the first thing is only risk 2% per trade. Now, we talked about this, and this is a good rule of thumb. And the reason why people say is, listen, most people have got your best interests at heart. You know, people don't give you advice out there that's bad advice. And that's good, because it means that if you're losing money, then you're not going to wipe out in a couple of trades. But the problem you have with this is that most people will start trading with a relatively small account. And if you're risking 2%, that's fine. And I'm definitely an advocate of that while you're learning. In fact, the smallest position size possible, the smallest risk, small, just on real money, the smallest thing possible, just to get some skin in the game and feel for that. And I feel that traders should stay on that for a long, long time. I'm an advocate of that. I've never made that a secret. I don't think demos are that worth. I don't think they're that useful. I think getting real money in is fine. And I just don't think there's any point in going crazy with size, even if you've got £250,000 to put at work. Just leave it for now. Just stick in a few thousand, get yourself rolling. But as by the by. The point is, 2% rule is to protect you, and it's good and it makes sense. But at some point, you're gonna wanna push. You're gonna know that the environment is very, very fertile. You're gonna know that things are working well, and you are in tune with a market that is offering opportunity. And so at that point, you are probably going to want to dial up the risk. And listen, there are recommendations, guys. These aren't personal things, it's just my opinions. Take them or leave them as you see fit, and you know, not offended if you don't agree with stuff. That's trading, guys. One person make money long, one person make money short. But I do believe that at some point, you've got to dial up that risk. 2% is fine for most of the time, and yes, but sometimes, guys, the market is trading beautifully. Sometimes you've got an edge that you need to press. And sometimes you might say, you know what? I'm gonna risk a fair bit of cash here. I'm gonna risk it. I'm prepared to take the risk. This is why we're saying about breaking rules. You're still planning and saying, listen, I might risk 5% on this trade. I might risk more. Yes, it's more size. Yes, it's this. But I'm trading well. The market's right. And if I get that set up, I'm gonna take it. I'm gonna take it on the chin if I lose. And as long as you're accepting the loss and understanding that, but recognizing that you're pushing your chips in a little bit more, I think that's fine. Just look back at some of the great trades throughout history. George Soros springs to mind. You know, when he broke the Bank of England, he made that big bet against the pound. He basically, from what I remember, is he basically put his whole profits in for the year onto that trade. Now, that's not risking a kind of standard amount throughout. He's recognizing this is a good trade. If I lose it, I'm not going to be out of the game forever. I'll have a losing year. I'll deal with it. But you know what? The odds are on my side. And the chips went in. And that's very similar for us, I think, is that when the opportunities are there, then press. It's not for everybody. Some people like that, but some people might say, okay, I feel like pressing. And if you feel like pressing and you're prepared to accept the consequences, then by all means, take more than 2% risk. You know, as long as you accept the consequences. Guys, when we fill out all the forms and stuff, we open accounts, disclaimers everywhere, you should know by now the risk involved in this game. And so you're a big boy, you're a big girl. You know, if you want to take the risk on it, the reward can be good, but you accept it. The other thing is, don't trade too much size. Yes, again, generalizing, it's a good rule to have. And for most beginner traders, for all beginner traders, stick to that. However, same kind of thing. When you recognize there's an advantage, it's time to dial up the size. Yes, it's going to sting a bit. Yes, it's going to be different. It's going to feel odd. But at some point, you've got to push a little bit. Same kind of thing. When you feel you've got that opportunity and that edge, put a little bit more risk on. If it's not working for you, come back. You know, protect, protect, protect. But at some point, you've got to step forward. You've got to move forward. Third thing is, take a break. Definitely advocate of this. Definitely, definitely, definitely. Constantly go on about this. And yes, for 99% of the time, taking a break is way better. However, sometimes, and again, I've measured this as well when we've talked about this, sometimes there are opportunities that are just relentless opportunities. You're there, you're trading European session, you're trading US session, and you're so focused. And by the end of it, you just want to go to sleep, you eat something, you go to sleep, you get up and do it again. But the opportunity's there. Like all these kind of things, it's knowing when to press the throttle right down and redline that engine, and then going back to the cruise and sitting at 3,000 RPM or whatever it may be. You know that there is opportunity to do that if it's right. And majority of the time, yes, you take a break. But if the opportunity's there, then, you know, maybe going away on holiday in the middle of the week doesn't make much sense, because you probably won't get this again for the next couple of years. So yes, take a break. For all majority of trading days, breaks are essential. They keep you focused, they help your performance massively. But sometimes you have to just focus and focus and focus. If it's working, and keep pushing, keep pushing, keep pushing. If it's not working, then you take the break. Number four, don't chase price. Again, most of the time, this is not the thing to do. If you're chasing price too much, you're going to get caught out. Sometimes price is moving in one direction and it is significantly out of tune with everything else. Supply demand imbalance is huge and you just have to get on board it. Now, you've got to be prepared for it to pull back. But you've done your due diligence and you said, hey, listen, you know what, this thing's just flying here. It's pulled back and it's ripping again. I need to just kind of bite the bullet and chase this. This is not FOMO. This is not chasing out of panic. This is a calculated chase. Very, very rare. And this is why most of these are very, very rare. But some conditions do warrant you having to just pay up. So you know what? It's breaking out. It's running. I'm going to have to pay up for this. The chances of it carrying on running are pretty high, and if it doesn't, I'll come out anyway. So sometimes you have to. I'm of the mind that majority of the time, you're better off waiting for retracements, pullbacks, some kind of move down to your level, talk about price coming to you rather than you going to price. But occasionally, you might have to go and start chasing things. The fifth one is, don't try to catch a falling knife. Now, this actually is a funny one, because most of these are, you know, rare occurrence where you occasionally have to break a textbook rule. But this one actually is a kind of thing that, for my trading anyway, I often catch a falling knife, and it works quite well for me, just because I feel like my edge comes from reading that shift in sentiment on a short-term time frame. So very often, you know, I will kind of flush, market will flush down, I'll spot the sweet spot and it pops back up, and you know, I'll take a trade from that. But the point is, guys, is that I've added this just as kind of reference, that these rules, all of these rules, and there's hundreds of them out there, right? We've talked about them before, and they are the best thing for the majority of the time. There's no doubt. And like I say, most people got your best interests at heart, and they're sharing rules that make sense and to keep you in the game longer. But just sometimes you've got to wonder when those rules kind of can be put aside. Can we just put aside for now and kind of trade it differently? You know, maybe in a situation, you know, bear market, market's driving lower, it's been in the bear market or big flushes for a long period of time, and you think, you know what, it just is the right time to start some buying, and you're not early, you feel like there's a sweet spot, there's reasons for it. Yes, people are like, oh, don't catch a falling knife, but that's where the opportunity is. Often it's a step in front of it at the point where you think you've got that low, and keep your risk managed and keep it tight, waiting for the pop. Because when it's popped, yes, there's still opportunities, of course, but you're the one that's way ahead of the game then. Now, I call these things, guys. These aren't for beginners. This isn't something that I definitely don't recommend for beginners. You want to stay in the game as long as possible. You want to be in the game, learning, experiencing market moves. So keeping risk low, you know, not trading size, small size, taking breaks and all these kind of good stuff. But occasionally, if you've got a bit of an edge now, if you've got a bit more, a few years under your belt, then, you know, sometimes you look at the textbook rules and say, no, not this time. This time I'm going to put a few more chips on the table. This time I'm going to take a bit more risk. But you know your trading, then you know what your risk should be. You know all the other things, and you can still mold a framework around it and have a rule-based system that you stick to for your own discipline. But sometimes they just don't contain some of the textbook rules. All right, guys, take care. See you next one. Bye-bye.